Hi, I'm Jimmy. In this video, we're looking at 5 dividend stocks that I'm looking to add to my bucket list because I believe these companies have the potential to be great buy and hold long-term dividend stocks. Now, these dividend stocks are companies that have consistently increased their dividends every year. So that's one of the keys for them making this list. They have to increase their dividend every year, even through 2020, which we know was a tough year for many, many companies. Okay, let's jump right in. So the first company is Medtronic, ticker symbol MDT. Medtronic currently has a dividend yield of about 2%. So not super high, but it does give us something to take home, and the company can continue to grow. The business can keep a bit of money to continue to grow the business and hopefully drive the stock higher. So hopefully we can get both. Now, I also think it's smart for us to be aware of, we don't want to overpay for any stock. So with that being said, Medtronic currently has a price to earnings ratio, a forward price to earnings ratio of 28x. So 28 times next year's profits. So I think it's smart to be aware of these ratios. So I'm going to include it for each company. So that's today's price versus the next 12 months of expected earnings. Hopefully using forward-looking numbers helps us shake out the bad 2020. That's why I'm using forward numbers, because sometimes when you have the entire economy is down and earnings drop, well, it will make, assuming the price stayed the same, it would make the price the price to earnings ratio look much higher than it actually is. So using forward hopefully eliminates some of that. Now, 28X is a bit high, so we're gonna want that to come down a bit. But as many of you may know, my personal favorite form of valuation for a stock is discounted free cash flow. So this is our calculation, my calculation of Medtronic's stock. And as we could see, well, I came up with a fair value for Medtronic's entire company of $118 per share. And then if we adjust that number, that's what this part is over here. When we adjust that number for debt, well, we end up with a fair value of their stock of $106 per share. So ideally, we want the stock to fall below 106. Right now, the stock is trading at about $120 per share. So if we can get it to fall below 106, I think that would be a very good buy. That's why I have a bucket list or a bullpen of stocks. That way I wait for them to get to the right price and make sure the research hasn't changed, jump in and buy it then. Now, since these are dividend stocks, well, we want to make sure that they can continue to increase their dividends. So when we pull up a chart of their dividend history, well, we can see that Medtronic has gradually increased their dividends over the past few years. This is exactly what we want to see. And then if we add their earnings per share to this chart, well, we can see that profit, that's the same thing as earnings per share, well, they more than cover the dividend, so that's a good sign. One potential negative for Medtronic seems to be that the profit-wise, they don't seem to be growing all that much. So we might want to do a deeper dive into this company before we go much further. With that in mind, if any of the companies that I talk about here, you think we should do a deeper dive, do a video on that company, please let me know in the comments below. I've got a company coming up in a minute that I think could really be worth it, but even this one could make a lot of sense. So let me know in the comments below. Okay, up next, now we have Home Depot, ticker symbol HD. Home Depot has a current dividend yield of about 2.2% and a forward price to earnings multiple of about 23x. So a little cheaper than Medtronic, but still a bit on the high end. Now, I've done a deeper dive on Home Depot a few times in the past, and I'm a big fan of the company. When we pull up their dividend history, well, we can see that it is in fact gradually marching higher, which is a great thing. And then when we add profits, profits, once again, are continuing to march higher. So overall, I'm a big fan of Home Depot stock. But when we look at my calculation of discounted free cash flow for Home Depot stock, well, we got a total company value of about $266 per share. And when we adjust that for debt, well, we end up with a fair value of about $241 per share. So Home Depot is currently trading at about $276. So it's a bit on the high end right now. I'd love to see it pull back below our debt adjusted calculation. If it got there, I think it would be a great buy. Okay, now if you're curious how to do this type of calculation, I actually did a whole video. This is an Excel template that I created on how to do this exact calculation. I walk through every step of this whole process. So if you're curious, I'll leave a link to that video in the description below. Okay, up next we have Pepsi, ticker symbol PEP. Pepsi has a dividend yield of about 3.1%. It's a little bit better than the other companies. And they have a forward PE multiple of about 22x. And then when we look at their dividend history, well, their dividends are gradually increasing, which again is exactly what we want. Then we add earnings per share. And as we might expect, they are consistently covering their dividends. So this is really in line with what we would expect. Now, Pepsi is a very mature company. I'm not too surprised that this would happen, but this could be a very good buy and hold stock. And then when we switch over to the fair value using discounted cash flow, well, we got a fair value of about $132 per share. Debt adjusted comes in at $106 per share. Now, Pepsi's trading slightly above $130 a share. So it's right in the range where we'd look to jump in. Now, for me, it would be a good buy if it got below our debt adjusted value, but to each his own on that. Okay, up next, we have Waste Management, ticker symbol WM. Waste Management has a dividend yield of about 2%, and they have a forward price to earnings ratio of about 28x. So a bit on the high end up there with some of our higher companies. And then when we shift over to the dividend history, well, we can see that they've done a good job of gradually marching their dividends higher. And when we add the earnings per share, well, once again, earnings per share more than cover their dividends. So this could prove to be a great dividend stock for the long run. This is one of those companies that is likely to do very good for a very long time. But if we're worried about where to buy it, over on our fair value discounted free cash flow calculation, well, here we got a company value of $117 a share. Debt adjusted turns out to be $94 a share. So right now, Waste Management is trading at about $112 per share. So again, I'd like to see it pull down. A lot of things, I know we've talked about that on different videos in this channel. A lot of things seem a bit overvalued. That's why I think it's good to identify where we think could be a good buy point. Okay, next up, our dividend stock that is a really interesting one. And this one could be worth a deeper dive, and that's the International Business Machines Company, or IBM for short, ticker symbols, also IBM. IBM currently has a dividend yield of about 5.5%, and they have a forward PE ratio of just 11x. So this could be either a great value or maybe a value trap, but it could be a good long-term dividend stock if we think that their business could turn around and head higher. Now, when we switch over to their dividend history, well, we can see that they've gradually increased their dividends. But then when we add earnings per share were a bit volatile for a while, but in 2020, it came out close. Yes, they covered their dividend, but just barely. Then when we switch over to their discounted free cash flow calculation, well, we got a fair value of about $251 per share for the entire company. They have a lot of debt, so we have to adjust that for debt. We end up with about $192 per share. But right now, IBM is trading at just $119 per share. So there's a huge gap between my calculation of fair value and their current stock price. Now, I know that they've got a lot of stuff going on. One good thing, for example, is in 2019, they bought Red Hat. One bad thing is that revenue profit has really been stagnant for the past few years. Now, they did just recently replace their CEO. So in start of 2021, they got a new CEO, so that could prove to be a good thing. And I know that they're spinning off some businesses and they're really breaking the company into two primary businesses. That partially explains why we're seeing a dip from last year actual numbers to projected numbers for free cash flow. So the question is, do we think that this is one of those companies? Do we think that IBM is one of the companies that could turn things around and start improving things? So this one could be worth a deeper dive. Now, with that being said, I like their high dividend yield, and I love dividends in general. I think that dividends give investors the power. You could take that, you can reinvest it back in the company, you can invest it in different companies, you could pay bills with it, you could do a lot with dividends. That's one of the advantages of dividends. But if you're curious to understand a bit more some of the drawbacks of dividends, well, I actually did a video where I called it The Harsh Truth of Dividends, and I talk about what happens to the stock when dividends get paid, and some nuances that we should understand about dividend investing. So if you're curious, perhaps that's a good next video for you to watch. I got a link right here. I got a link in the description below. Thank you so much for sticking with me all the way to the end of the video. I really appreciate it. Thanks, and I'll see you in the next video.